I will be talking about improving intercultural communication. Along with anything in life, intercultural communication can be improved by giving one thing, and that's effort. If you give effort to anything and everything that you do, there is so much that a person could accomplish. There are various ways you can improve your intercultural communication, and the first way I'm going to talk about is by joining an intercultural training program. In the intercultural training program, they focus on three things. They focus on changing your thinking, changing your feelings, and changing your behavior. Changing your thinking. When people increase their knowledge about a culture, they tend to develop a more complex way about viewing that culture. This then helps reduce negative stereotypes and allows others to appreciate other cultures more efficiently. Changing feelings. When people experience less anxiety when communicating with other cultures, they feel more comfortable and more positive about those intercultural exchanges. Changing behavior. When a person's thoughts or feelings are altered, their behavior often becomes altered. So people tend to develop better interpersonal relationships when they know what to say and what to do. You can also be mindful. Many of our communication attitudes and behaviors are so rooted in our culture that it's actually unconscious. For example, talking distance. In America, we automatically know where to stand when we're talking to someone, but other cultures might find it offensive. We might be too close to them or maybe too far away. So we need to take into account how our actions may affect them. Another example would be when we're greeting people. In America, we like to place our hand out for a handshake. Other cultures like to bow, or they'll give a kiss on either side of the cheek. So if we know what that culture does when they greet each other, we should try to accommodate to their needs. You can also desire to learn. Learning cultural specific information can be useful in intercultural communication. It increases awareness about other cultures around the world, and it prepares you to adapt to certain customs that may be present in the United States. So, how do you learn about other cultures? You can ask respectful and earnest questions to people from that culture. You can try different foods from different countries. You can study their scripture and see what their faith is. Or you can even study abroad if you want to be totally immersed. Overcome intergroup biases. It's good to learn about other cultures, but it's recommended that you have face-to-face contact with people from that culture. And often when you have these face-to-face contacts, you will encounter the intergroup contact theory, which is interaction between members of different social groups that generates a possibility for a positive attitude to emerge. This gives everyone a chance to understand and appreciate others' cultures more. Often, when we have these face-to-face interactions, we also encounter behavioral affirmation, which is seeing or hearing what you want to. So, for example, if someone believes that all teenagers are lazy and they have a teenage sister, no matter how hard she works at school or she does all of her chores, they will always think that she's lazy. Then you may also have people that engage in behavioral confirmation, which is acting in a way that makes your expectations a reality. So again, if you have a sister, you can give her a task that's not too hard, but she ultimately doesn't really pass at it. You will still have that mind, well, told you all teenagers are lazy. So we need to be aware of our own behaviors and our biased perceptions when we are interacting with other cultures. We also need to accommodate appropriately. We need to make small efforts to show that we respect others' cultural communication behaviors. So for example, I took French in high school for 4 years and I had the opportunity to go to Europe for a couple months ago. And when I was over in Europe, I tried to speak in French every time I got a chance. So when I was ordering my food or asking for directions, and although it wasn't the best French that anyone's seen, you could definitely tell that they were appreciative for the effort that I tried to put into it. But we also need to be careful to not over-accommodate. So for example, speaking down to elders. We don't need to slow our speech down or increase our volume or use childish terms. Yes, some elderly people do need those needs, but not everyone is like that. And last but not least, you need to practice your skills. Communications with fewer social skills have the most difficulty in intercultural communication. So you need to listen effectively. You need to know when to talk and when to be quiet. Listening is just as important as talking. You need to think before you speak. when someone communicates in a way that seems strange or doesn't really make you feel comfortable, you need to think about how his or her behavior might be a cultural difference rather than them being hostile towards you. You need to be empathetic. When you develop empathy, it changes your perception and improves your understanding of other people's cultures. And do the right thing. Stand up for someone who's being mocked for his race, religion, or sexual orientation. Fight for those who don't have a voice.
These are our sources, and we're Lincoln Crackles. Thank you very much.